Hello YouTube people, today I'll show you the watch which I don't really like. There are objective and subjective reasons why I don't like this watch, we'll talk about it. But the first question is, why have I bought this watch if I don't like it? Well, I didn't know. I had this Cadison which I like a lot and I wanted to try out something else. So I bought this Parnes watch which looks very similar. I like it very much, so I wanted something else. I bought these two Cadison watches. Review about this one sometime in the future. So about this one, it's a little bit different as you see from this Cadison. This one has only date and this one has day and date, so it's interesting. I wanted to try this out, gave it a go. Slightly disappointed, but that's the point of this video, we'll tell you everything about it. Let's just start with the positive points, okay? So, I have three Cadison watches right now. I wanna say that I'm constantly surprised by the quality of their bracelets. This was my first Cadison watch. Incredible quality of the bracelet. Wonderful. This one came also with the same bracelet. Also wonderful bracelet, incredible quality. And the third Cadison also, incredible quality, wonderful bracelet. All the edges are very soft, the finishing is incredible. The brush surfaces are nice, polished surfaces are nice. And the fitment inside the lugs, there is no gap, everything fits together so nicely. It's wonderful bracelet, feels expensive, looks expensive, amazing. The clasp, also very good clasp. No sharp edges, it's just great, it's just very good. Another positive thing would be the case, the finishing of the case. It's nothing really amazing, there are no transitions between polished or brushed surfaces like on something like Casio Edifice watches. It's a simple, but it's very nicely polished out. I see no scratches, nothing out of place. I mean, it's just a very nice case, and this bezel also looks very nice in person. Everything fits very well. It's a great case, can't really complain about that. Another thing, positive thing, is the price. I paid 88 euros for this watch, and I think it's a pretty good price for what you get. The bracelet alone is incredible, and you also get this Miyota movement, and Miyota movements are known to be rather reliable movements. It has 5 bars of water resistance, 50 meters, which is pretty good for this style of the watch, I would say. So, let's move on towards the negative things. Okay, speaking about negative things, I have split them into 2 parts. First part is objective things, and other part is just my stupid opinion, so completely subjective. And let's start with objective things. First of all, if I say that the watch has sapphire, I always test myself to make sure. And this time the window is sapphire, but the Cyclop is not. I had this Cadison and the window is sapphire and the Cyclop is sapphire as well. I bought 2 other Cadison watches expecting that they're gonna be full sapphire. These two. And on both of these watches, the Cyclop is not sapphire. I mean, and they don't note anywhere on their selling page that the Cyclop is not sapphire. I mean, this is just not nice. I don't know, is this some kind of a mistake or something? But not telling clients that the Cyclop is not sapphire, I would say it's not nice. Because it's the first thing it's sticking out, the first thing you're gonna scratch up. And what's the point of the window being sapphire if the Cyclop itself is not a sapphire? It's not good. It's just not good, okay? It's not nice. That Cyclop doesn't really magnify much. It does magnify a little bit, but not to the point where you would say, oh, it's nice Cyclop. You know, I like the design of a Cyclop as a design feature, but when I look at the date and I see that the Cyclop doesn't do much, it's like, oh, so it's fake. It gives that feeling, it's like, oh, it cheapens the look so badly. So that's objective negative thing. So even I have told you that Miyota movement is good for this price, and yes, it's good because people say it's very reliable. The negative thing is that this rotor winds the wedge only in one direction and it spins freely in other direction. So sometimes I catch this wedge making a little bit too much noise. It's like a fidget spinner inside the wedge. If you move your hand a little bit too much in certain angle, in certain direction, it just spins inside, the watch itself wobbles, and it gives cheap feel. I already fixed one watch with such rotor. I lubricated the rotor and now everything is fine, so it's fixable, but I still putting that to objective negative things. Okay, the final objective negative thing is the misalignment problems. I'm gonna struggle a little bit to show you that on camera, but I'll try my best. So there are two problems with misalignment. First problem is that Cadisson logo and Cadisson brand name are not coming together in the center very nicely. Logo seems to be applied very nicely in the center, while the Cadisson name seems to be printed a little bit towards the right side. And I so wish that the V-shape pointing down of Cadisson logo would be aligned very nicely with Cadisson eye. And now every time I look at this, it just looks so off. I just can't unsee that. And the second problem with misalignment is that indexes themselves, our number 4, 6, and 7, I understand these sticks are difficult to be placed nicely in a rounded shape to look aligned well. But I mean, no matter how I try to look at these indexes at hour 4, 6 and 7, they still seem a little bit off. I don't know, maybe my eyes are showing something not right, but you see for yourself. Tell me in the comments, do you see something off? Okay, that's it. That's all objective negative things. Now let's move to my stupid opinion, to subjective negative things. And the first thing is the size for the style. I mean, this style of the watch is a little bit posh. It's a little bit luxurious, shouty looking style for this watch. And you see, when such watch is made in small size, instead of looking vulgar, it looks kinda cute. It looks fine, it looks a little luxurious, nice watch. It doesn't look vulgar, it's nice watch. But when the watch is sized up a little bit, when it's rather big watch, it doesn't look cute anymore. It looks a little bit shouty, look at me, I'm rich. And so it's a little bit vulgar. I don't know, if you have big hands and you make this watch look small on your big hands, maybe that's all right. But on my hands that are 16.5 centimeters, this watch looks a little bit too big for me. It's too shouty, too vulgar. It's completely subjective. Another subjective negative thing, for example, this Cadisson and this Cadisson as well, they have such a beautiful, nice, polished inside wall. Inside, well, they don't really have chapter ring, but inside wall is polished and just looks incredible, wonderful. This one as well has this polished inside wall, but on this inside wall it has Cadisson logo all over the place. Cadisson, Cadisson, Cadisson. I mean, this watch already has a lot of things going on. This bezel looking crazy, these our indexes with a lot of sticks looking crazy, this day and date complication. And on top of that, it has Cadisson logo all over the place on the sidewall. I mean, that's a little bit too much. It looks a little bit too busy. Instead of looking clean, elegant, it kills the elegance completely. It just, for me, just my opinion. Another thing which is personal opinion is I see this mistake, well, mistake, it's just my opinion, on many watches, on many very expensive watches as well. I mean, the watch itself is like monotone. It's silver and black. It doesn't have colors. Stylistically wise, color wise, it's very elegant. Yet on this black dial, it has this white printed text. I mean, white printed text on this black dial, on this style of a watch, it just cheapens the look of the watch so much. And I do see the same mistake on very expensive watches as well when I watch reviews on YouTube. I just don't understand. I mean, if the text was a little bit toned down, a little bit silver, it's a little bit gray, that will look all right. But white, simple printed text on luxurious looking watch, on luxurious style, it just doesn't work whatsoever. And speaking about the text, why there is Cadison name? There is already a logo applied. It's just, it's too busy, it's too much, as I mentioned about Cadison on that chapter ring. So there is Cadison logo, Cadison brand name as well. And under the Cadison name, there is also automatic. I mean, it's far too many things going on. Why would you need that automatic under Cadison name? I just don't understand. That automatic would look much better above water resistance. And speaking about water resistance, it's not some kind of a gym Casio watch. Why do you need a spreadsheet on a watch like 21 joules, 5 atmosphere water at automatic? I mean, come on. I'm not a fan of too much text on the face or on a watch. Sometimes that text looks nice, like on Invicta Pro Diver. But on Invicta Pro Diver, that text is printed in such a nice way, and it's not white, it's silver color. It looks good, even though that there is a lot of text, it is done in a nice way. It looks good. On this watch, this white text all over the place, it just kills the watch completely for me. And now, towards the end of the video, let's remember one thing. This watch costs about 90 euros. I mean, this is not some kind of a 1,000 euro watch. And I laid out those negative things like it was a 1,000 euro watch. But now remember, it costs around 890 euros. So, you know, it's not like it's the end of the world. Yeah, but still. Where I gonna put this watch on my website, thomaswatchreviews.com. I am putting this watch into nope tier. You know, I just, as you can see, I just don't find connection with this watch. This watch just doesn't work for me. And I hope I have told you all the things why it doesn't work for me in a clear way. I don't know if you agree with me or not, but that's just completely my opinion. And this tier list for watches is also completely just my opinion. So I do not recommend buying this watch. I am putting this watch into nope tier. Sorry, Cadison. I don't want to insult you. But I mean, don't put mineral crystal cyclops on watches that you list as a sapphire crystal. That's just not nice. Okay, thank you guys for watching. Have a beautiful day. Goodbye.